Before we get into how to use the FX compressor inside FL Studio Mobile, I'm going to explain to you how compressing the audio would make the audio louder. I know at first glance, it does not make sense, but I'm going to explain it to you. So let's say we have this input audio signal. We have the soft part, which is at negative 2 dB, and the loud part is at negative 1 dB. And right now, let's add a speaker to it. And the thing you gotta understand about the speaker is that there is a maximum loudness the speaker can output. So usually it's 0 dB, but for this example's sake, let's put it at negative 1 dB. So there is a maximum loudness, negative 1 dB. If you put in a signal of negative 1 dB, it's gonna be very loud. Anything softer is gonna be lower, right? Negative 2 dB, negative 4 dB, negative 10 dB. So right now, let's run this signal through the speaker and see what comes out. So what comes out is exactly the same. The loud part is at negative 1 dB while the soft part is at negative 2 dB. Now let's try to apply compression to the input signal. We're gonna compress the loud parts so that it is same volume as the soft parts, negative 2 dB. The soft part in relation to the loud part, there is no difference in terms of loudness. So let's try running this through the speaker and see what comes out. Ta-da! Because the maximum loudness the speaker can put in is negative 1 dB, and because the loudness relation of the soft part to the loud part is exactly the same, both of them have the same loudness of negative 1 dB, effectively increasing the volume of our soft part. So that's how compression could actually make your overall audio signal or vocal louder. Now on to the tutorial. This is the soft part of the song. This is the loud part of the song. Okay, so we have the soft part of the song and also the loud part of the song. Now on to the actual plugin. So to add it, just press on plus, press on compressor, and you see something called FX compressor inside your FX tab. And there is knobs here like trash for threshold, ratio, attack, hold, release, and also level. What are these? So first of all, the threshold and also the ratio are very closely related. For threshold is the limit where the audio hits in terms of loudness, where the compressor would come in to compress the audio. So basically, it's just a limit of loudness for when the compression would come in. Now to know what level of loudness in terms of dB that your threshold should be, you just go inside here, press on plus and select FX leveler, this one. When you play your audio, you would know how loud in terms of dB is your soft parts and how loud in terms of dB for your loud parts. So let's play it. This is the soft part of the song. So I would say the soft part is at around negative 35 dB, hovering around there. This is the loud part of the song. And the loud part is at around negative 20 dB. In order for it to trigger so that all the sound is at negative 20 dB gets compressed, I'm going to put the threshold at around negative 30 dB. So anything louder than negative 30 dB will get compressed. So just drag this knob down all the way to negative 30. And if you play this, you realize nothing will happen. This is the loud part of the song. Next is the ratio. This controls how much signals get compressed. So if earlier our loud signal is around minus 20 dB, if I put the ratio 2:1, that means you get compressed from minus negative 20 dB to minus 40 dB. So let's put a 2 overall there, and the overall signal would be automatically increased because there is an automatic gain inside FX compressor. This is the soft part of the song. This is the loud part of the song. So immediately you realize that both the soft part and also the loud part is hovering at negative 20 dB. So we effectively increase the loudness of our audio signal or vocal. So these sections of threshold and ratio sort of control when the compressor come in and how much compression is applied to the audio signal. So the next section, attack, hold and release, controls when the compressor comes in, when is it getting hold and when is it stopped. So it kind of controls the intro, the story, and also the ending of it. So I'm going to explain this using a car brake analogy, alright? Attack is from when the compressor comes in to when it reached the full compression. So let's say I was driving and suddenly I saw an obstacle in front and I started pressing the brake. So the moment I start press the brake to the moment where I press the brake fully, that is the attack. So for hold is how long the compressor would hold on to the signal, even though the signal loudness level has dropped below the threshold level. Now this is used when there is very quick, loud and soft noises, and you want the compressor to hold throughout the whole entire signal even though it is very chaotic. So you use this hold to make sure the compressor turns on all the time. So next is the release, is from when the audio signal drops below a certain loudness level and the compressor stops acting until the compression hits a full zero. So in our driving example, the moment there is no more obstacle, you want to let go of the brake. To the moment you fully let go of the brake, that time delay is the release. Now all of these three things, attack, hold and release, is used to control the characteristics of your compression, and normally it is used when your vocals is paired together with other instruments and you want to see how that whole compression plays out to the overall ending resulting sound. Last but not least, it is the level knob. Now this level knob is for you to increase the gain after you have done all your compression. We call this the makeup gain. So after you have compressed your entire audio signal, you want to increase it back to a certain level, you can use this level to increase the level of your audio signal. This is the soft part of the song. This is the loud part of the song. So it can go pretty loud there. And that's how to use the FX compressor inside FL Studio Mobile. Hopefully right now you know exactly how compressor works, how compressing the audio will make the audio louder. So if you find that this video is really helpful, do hit the like button down below. It tells YouTube that this is a good video and YouTube would show this to even more people. It's totally free. Hit the like button down below. And I know you guys hear me say this for a long time already, I'm trying to enter this YouTube pilot program where currently right now I have 2,958 watch hours. Recently I have this video FL Studio tutorial for beginners, which I think is performing really well. So if you're one of the viewers that came from that video, thank you for being here. I really appreciate you. If you have questions on FL Studio or music production, leave it down in the comments. I'll try my best to answer them in a future video. If you want to learn more about FL Studio and FL Studio Mobile, I'll put the playlist right here. And if you don't have a lot of time, you just want to watch one video, your mom is scolding you, go do your homework, boy, then you can watch a video recommended by YouTube right here. Until then, guys, I'll see you in the next video. Bye.